Oh, why hello there. Welcome back to my channel. Nice to have you once again. If it's your first time here, you know what to do. Smash that like, hit subscribe, and leave me a comment down below. God damn it, I thought I would never have to talk about these people on my channel ever in the history of the world, in the history of time. I thought I'd never have to talk about these people, but here we are. Daddy has to pay some bills and ensure that his trainer collection keeps on stacking higher and higher and higher. So that brings me on to this topic of today's conversation. Khloe Kardashian and the Kardashian family embody dysmorphia. What the hell is going on? Why is this any of our business? Why is this any of our business? I blame this mostly on lockdown and COVID. I think any other time in history, we probably wouldn't be caring this much about such insignificant and trivial matters. But because we're all locked indoors and we have nowhere else to go, we're all stuck on our phones, even though we're pretending we're not, we are now consuming news that has little, if nothing, to do with us, and we are making it big as it actually shouldn't be. And here exactly we are. So over the weekend, or the last few days, the internet was ablaze with rumors and whispers that the Kardashian clans were going around and hitting all these random little news sites and Instagram pages that kind of, you know, entire MO is predicated around the idea of uncovering the truth of some of the glitzy, beautiful women out there who happen to reside primarily in Hollywood. Now, I've only stumbled across these pages recently because I'm kind of naive and I'm straight, so I'm not exactly glued onto some of these cosmetic surgery platforms and pages and stuff and understanding who has fill and who hasn't. But it's been an absolute revelation. I'm not gonna lie, it's been a revelation for a guy like myself to see, oh my god, all of these females that I was getting excited for when I was creeping on the Instagrams have mostly had some kind of enhancement to make them look the way they look. Was interesting and eye-opening for me. But that was exactly it. I couldn't see it from the point of view of a young female, because guess what, I'm not a young female. But over time, I got a bit of an understanding over reading the comments and seeing what people have posted and seeing how positive they've actually reacted and how much comfort is brought them to see pictures of somebody that they idolized and thought was perfect, but then they uncovered that actually whatever perfect that they think was perfect was actually a procedure that cost upwards of $100,000 and took 6 months to heal. You could see that it actually brings these young girls who are on these pages some level of comfort of knowing that these airbrushed pictures that they're seeing are in fact enhanced under the knife. So it gives them some level of comfort to know, you know, line myself up to these kind of unattainable beauty standards. Cool, no problem. And I don't really have an issue with the Kardashians either. I think this materialistic, narcissistic, you know, family thing that they have going on is perfectly fine. I think everybody plays a role in this world that we live in, and if that's the role that they designed or that they've been put on this earth to play, and I think it's all intent okay. The only problem I have with it is when you wrap me up and get me involved in your hypocrisy, your lies, and I have to be part of your delusion. That's where I say enough is enough, and this weekend was a good example of it. So over the weekend, the Kardashian family were working overboard to get a picture removed of Khloe Kardashian from the internet because she deemed it to be unworthy of exposure. And what exactly was the picture? What was so bad that was getting the internet up in a tizzy? Just her looking decidedly normal in a bikini was the picture that incensed their entire family. And if we're led to believe what we read on the internet, might have caused a rift in her own family. Hear this right. Khloe Kardashian might have fell out with her gran because she decided, or unbeknownst to her, decided to uplift and celebrate her granddaughter by sharing a picture of her by the pool onto her social media platform, and eagle-eyed observers snatched it and uploaded it and said, hey, this is what she actually looks like, and not those other pictures she posted up on her feed. She might have actually fallen out with her grandmother for posting a picture of herself of what she actually looks like. Now, that makes complete sense because it's her body. She can do exactly what she pleases with it. She's not happy with the picture. Fair enough. But it's this thing that we're having to now, it's like I feel like we're all in a group body dysmorphia session. Like we're having to now console and take part in this issue that has nothing to do with us. How she looks like on the Instagram feed, even if it's edited, that's cool if you want to stay that way. No problem whatsoever. How you look beside the swimming pool, that's cool too. No problem whatsoever. But then don't try and tell us that both of those pictures are not edited, and both of those pictures are completely normal, and both of those pictures are exact perfect representation of what you actually look like in real life. That's the thing that's actually throwing me off about this whole thing. So of course she goes out there, sends a DMCA request to various pages. The article itself says the following. Team Kardashian is going into overdrive to erase a private photo showing a side of Khloe few outside of her family get to see. Demon shows the reality star face and body as she appears in a bikini by the pool, without the heavy editing and airbrushing that our mainstays and the photos of Kardashian normally put on Instagram. But we didn't know that, right? They're mainstays because we know, and because I found out as of what, a couple of weeks ago, because I started following these Instagram pages. But most people don't know this. That's the actual harmful part of this whole equation. It's okay to live in a dreamland and to live around your fakery, but if everyone knows this fakery, then that's okay. But then don't lie to us that it's not fakery, and then put pressure on these young, impressionable young ladies in order to reach a level of beauty that cannot be reached, because you spent all the money in the world, you've got all the resources in the world to make you look whatever you want to look like, and you're still not happy. So how about this girl that's just, you know, in school, you know, working part-time somewhere? How's she ever gonna end up looking like that if that's her goal? It's never gonna happen, because guess what? That body doesn't exist. Anyway, it continues. The shot, which Page Six has confirmed is authentic, soon spread around the internet, but many copies of the photo were taken down under legal threats from the Kardashians camp, which called the image beautiful, but said they wanted it gone because it was unauthorized. What? Your grandmother sent it? Didn't she upload it? Where else did it come from? It wasn't like she got her iCloud account got hacked or something. She uploaded it unbeknownst to her, not knowing that you're not allowed to upload raw images to the internet if you're part of the Kardashians clan. They have to go through a filter. They might have some sort of like cloud that actually goes into, and then, you know, various photo editors from around the world painstakingly go through it and make sure everything is clipped and smoothed wherever it needs to be. It continues. The color edited photo was taken of Khloe during a private family gathering and posted on social media without permission by mistake by an assistant. Oh yeah, yay. They're throwing the assistant under the bus there. It continues. The photo was posted on social media, but many copies were taken down under legal threats of Kardashian camp. It says, yeah, Khloe looks beautiful, but it's within the right of the copyright owner to not want the image intended to be published and taken down. Have they ever heard of the Barbra Streisand effect? Right, the more you try to remove an image from the internet, the more that image is going to spread like wildfire. And that's exactly what happened. If they just would have ignored it and continued as per normal and kept uploading and acting like it didn't happen, this would be a dead issue. But trying to convince us that this isn't an issue and you actually are okay with what you want to look like in that picture, but you want a picture gone, doesn't make any sense. It doesn't compute. Our heads end up exploding. That ends up happening, and of course they end up replying and posting one of the most bizarrest replies I've ever seen in my entire life. I have to reiterate, this isn't an issue. This doesn't really matter. No one really cares. The lady looks beautiful in either pictures. It doesn't matter. But it's this idea that you're now convincing us that what we're seeing isn't real, and you're involving us in your body dysmorphia and your own psychosis. Why can't you just deal with it in private like everyone else does? We all have issues. We're all going through things. Our brains are fried. We've been indoors for the best part of a year. Our career prospects have gone down the drain. Some of our family members are no longer here. Our relationships are strained. Our education, further education, we don't know when we're going to go back to college, when we're going to go back to higher education, university, all that malarkey. The job we had lined up is dead. We haven't been on holiday in over a year. We have our own issues, but guess what we do? We bury that stuff deep down inside like a grown-up. That's what we do. That's how we maneuver in the world. We don't put it all up there in the open for everyone to see, and then we complain about their reactions. That's not what we do. We grow up and we act like adults. Here's a very non-adult reply from the Kardashian, courtesy of Popbase. Says the following. Khloe Kardashian reveals why she asked her team to remove the unedited bikini photo from the internet. She didn't even have the guts and the balls to come up and front it herself. She had to get one of her minions to go out there and take down the picture, and in some cases ruin the business of, guess what, young females trying to be entrepreneurial and set up these pages in order to bring comfort to other young females are now being threatened with legal actions, which is going to drastically and negatively affect their business all in. Absolutely ridiculous. The statement goes as follows. Hey guys, this is me and my body. Yeah, okay, whatever. Unretouched and unfiltered. The photo that was posted this week is beautiful. But as someone who has struggled with body image for her whole life, when someone takes a photo of you that isn't flattering in a bad lighting or doesn't capture your body the way it's after working so hard to get at this point, then share this to the world. You should have every right to ask for it not to be shared regardless of who you are. Fuck off. You're the one that set the unattainable beauty standards. You are part of it. You are complicit in this issue. You are complicit in this issue, and now you're making it seem as if you're the victim. Honestly, this is epic. Mwah. Chef kiss. In truth, the pressure and the constant ridicule and judgment my entire life to be perfect and meet everyone's standards. Oh my God, this woman is insufferable. Khloe is a fat sister. Khloe is the ugly sister. Her dad must not be her real dad because she looks so different. The only way she could have lost the weight is with surgery. Should I go on? But, you obviously don't look like this in real life. What is this? Honestly, these people are insane. Everything she said is legit. She has very legit concerns. But she clearly doesn't look like that in real life. And she's within her right to change and edit her face however she pleases. If that makes her feel comfortable in presenting her face on social media. Fair. Cool. But if we then see a picture of your actual face and we say, oh, wow, that's different. We're allowed to say that's different. And we're also not bullying you by saying that's different. And we're also not putting unfair beauty standards on you by saying that's different. Because guess what? You edited that picture. So by theory, you're the one that's setting yourself unfair beauty standards by posting this picture of yourself on social media in an attempt to rewrite the narrative that you actually look like this in real life when you don't. You live by the sword, you die by the sword. You never quite got used to being judged and pulled apart, told how unattractive one is. But I will say, if you hear anything enough, then you start to believe it. This is an example of how I've been... Oh, shut up, mate. I love a good filter. Really? We didn't know. I love a good lighting. Oh, really? We didn't know. An edit here and there. Here and there, she said. Here and there. The same way I throw on some makeup and get my nails done and wear a pair of heels or present myself in the world is the way that I've been. The way I want to be seen is exactly what I will continue to do unapologetically. Oh, yeah, we know. Don't worry. My body, my image, and how I choose to look and what I want to share is my choice. How did she turn this in? Honestly, this is expert. I don't even know. This isn't even gaslighting. Whatever this is expert spin. This is an issue that she created, a mistake that happened within her own family, and now she's turned it into a thing to like attack us, the viewer. What did we do? We did nothing wrong. We were minding our business on social media, scanning through, la-di-di, la-di-di, la-di-da, and then we spotted something that threw us for a loop because we're used to seeing this girl look like whatever she looked like previously, and now we're being lectured to body acceptance and being comfortable in one's skin and unapologetic in your filtering use. What the flip is going on? Oh, but who cares how she feels, because she grew up in a life of privilege. She's also on a reality TV show, signed all this. I'm of course not asking for sympathy. Yes, you are. You clearly are asking for sympathy. Anytime somebody writes a wall of text and posts it on Instagram slides, you are insanely, intensely, and persistently asking for sympathy. I'm of course not asking for sympathy. Yes, you are, but I'm asking for it to be acknowledged for being human. Oh my God, man. I'm human. I'm not perfect. Oh, shut up. Then it continues. I'm not perfect, but I promise. See, she even said it. I didn't even know that she even said it. But I promise that I will try every day of my life to be honestly as possible. You can start by telling us how many surgeries you've got. Again, none of our business, but if you're going to talk about honestly, let's get honest. It doesn't mean that I have not made mistakes, but I'm not going to lie. It's almost unbearable trying to live up to the impossible standards that the public have set for me. Oh my God. Is there no acceptance or responsibility that you have to accept for the role that you played in these unfair beauty standards? Again, I'm no expert on the Kardashians. I'm aware of what she said previously in the earlier part of the statement. Maybe she has a point. Maybe she is the battering ram and the person that everyone kind of goes and kind of throws insults at when they want to attack the Kardashians. Maybe for a long period of time she had to suffer in silence and now she's finally blossoming and living her best life. Cool. All right. Safe. But aren't you contributing to some level of these unachievable beauty standards by perpetuating this myth that you look like the way you look like on your Instagram feed when it's quite clear you don't? And it's quite clear when you get captured in that light, you don't like the way you look, and you want to then take down that picture from the internet and in the process ruin people's livelihood by striking their accounts or whatever it may be. It's insane. I'm not perfect, but I promise that I'll try every day of my life to live as honestly as possible with empathy and kindness. It doesn't mean that I have not made mistakes, but I'm not going to lie. It's almost unbearable to live up to the impossible standards that the public have set for me. For over a decade now, in photos, every single flaw and imperfection has been microanalyzed and made fun of the smallest detail. And when I take that criticism to use as motivation to get myself in the best shape of my life and even help others in the same struggles, I'm now told I've done it through hard work and I must have paid for it all. No one is saying you haven't done some level of hard work, but please acknowledge some of the assistance that you've received. This family are insane. Again, they don't owe anybody explanations, but if you get called out, you then can't use the fact that you've supposedly got a real body as a defense mechanism. That doesn't work. If you get called out for whatever you get called out for, just ignore it and keep it moving. But then don't try and then loop us into your dysmorphia and get us involved in your issues in your own head. You have to sleep at night with your own issues, as we do. We all have our own things that we sleep at night with, but we don't burden others with it or try and get them involved in our psychosis. That is literally insane. And then to make matters worse, she decided to upload the video to prove, I guess, in motion, that she looks like the way she looks like. The video has a filter on it too. There's a filter on the video that glitches somewhere around her waist that I've been made aware at. And for some reason, Kim decided to come out at the end and blow us a kiss. Why? To reassure us that, guys, everything's okay. We don't actually care though. You're the one that cares. Supposedly towards the front of this video, there's a glitch around her waist. Again, I'm not too familiar with it, but supposedly that is what happens. There's a glitch around her waist area where you then see that she put a video filter, which I didn't even know these things exist. There are video filters. Video filters exist where you can make your face look a certain way in video format whilst you're moving and doing your thing and laughing and joking and updating your followers on your day. You can apply a filter. And she did that in order to fight back to against the haters. She can't even balance on one leg. Bruv, what is wrong with these people? What is wrong with these people? Please, someone tell me. Am I going insane or are these people insane? Please smash like if they're going insane. And dislike if they're not going insane. Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks again for checking out the show. Peace.